This video will cover binomial distributions. So what is a binomial distribution? First, it's a way to evaluate discrete events. A binomial distribution will either happen or not happen. It's one or the other. It's also an application of a mass function. So when you look at a binomial distribution, the equation looks like this, where the probability of x equaling xk is equal to n choose x times the past probability raised to the x power times 1 minus the past probability raised to the n minus x. What do these variables mean? Well, n is the number of trials and x is the number of desired outcomes, while rho is the past probability and n choose x is n factorial divided by x factorial divided by n minus x factorial. And remember, probability p of x equaling some outcome of x sub k is the actual probability of desire. Now by itself, this is a probability mass function. But remember, you can always sum probability mass functions to create cumulative mass functions. So let's take an example. I want to know what the probability is of rolling a dice and getting the number 6. Well, of course, there's 6 sides to a dice, so the probability is 1/6. We want to answer 2 questions. In the next 10 rolls, what's the probability of rolling the number 5 twice? So what I'm saying is, I'm going to roll the dice 10 times, and exactly 2 of them, I'll get the number 5. To solve this, we say the probability of x equaling 2 is 10 factorial divided by 2 factorial divided by 8 factorial times 1/6 square times 5/6 to the 8th power. And this is 29%. Please note that this is a PMF, a probability mass function, where we know the exact probability for x to happen twice. Next, we want to think about, what about rolling the number 5 fewer than 2 of the times? In that case, we're looking at the probability that x is less than or equal to 2. It includes 2, but fewer. That means the probability that x equals 0 plus the probability of x equaling 1 plus the probability of x equaling 2. This is a cumulative mass function, and it can be solved by adding the 3 quantities. And the final answer would be 78%. We will do additional examples like this during class, but you can use this for any type of situation. You can evaluate the level of water in a reservoir or the amount of water in a lake or a river to determine whether the probability will exceed or not exceed.